Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is Ravi Gupta. Today I am going to talk about the cooling water system diagram. First I will show you the simplified cooling water system diagram, and after that I will show you the advanced cooling water system diagram incorporating the PID controller. The cooling water system will be explained in two part. The part 1 will consist of the diagram, and in part 2 I will explain the mode of cooling and why the cooling, which cooling method is preferred, advantage of freshwater cooling. And in part 2 also I will explain the auxiliary cooling water system and the different component of the cooling water system, why it is used and why it is provided. So please watch the both part. So let's begin the part 1 with the diagram. So as you can see here, this is the cooling water system of the main engine. Basically what happened, this is the main engine, this is the header tank, this is the HT cooler, and this is the cooling water pump, and this is the heater. Now the cool water from the HT cooler is coming out, and it been pumped by the cooling water pump, and its pressure is been raised around 4 to 5 bar. That water, depending upon its temperature, means of the inlet, which should be maintained around 68 to 70 degrees Celsius, is passed through this, and after that it passes through liner jacket, then exhaust valve cooling and turbocharger cooling. After carrying out these three things, it comes out from the top and it returns back to the cooler. Now while returning back to the cooler, there is a three-way valve provided which decide the amount of cooling required for the jacket water cooler. In the three-way valve, it will mix up the cooling jacket water and the heated jacket water such that the inlet temperature of the jacket water is maintained 68 to 70 degrees Celsius. The amount of mixing is been controlled by throttling the valve of the water coming out from the jacket and the water coming out from the cooler by taking the temperature from the outlet of the jacket. So basically what happened, the inlet temperature is around 60 to 70 degrees Celsius and the outlet temperature is 78 to 82 degrees Celsius. Now this 8 degree is the rise in temperature occur because it extract the heat, combustion heat, from the liner wall and is taken out by the jacket water providing cooling. Now to replenish any leakage in the tank, basically a header tank is provided. As you can see here, the header tank. This header tank will compensate for any water leakage from the gland or pump or cooler, or loss due to evaporation also. And as you can see here, a heater is provided. Basically the heater function is to heat the inlet liquid, when the engine is in a standstill condition. When the engine is running, at that time the these two valve is closed, but when the engine is stopped, at that time, to ensure that the system temperature is maintained around 68 to 75 degrees Celsius, this heater is provided which uses the steam from the boiler to heat up the liquid cooling water so that the temperature is maintained around 68 to 75 degrees Celsius. Why the heater is provided? The heater is provided so that the sudden thermal stress because of the change in temperature, means suppose when the if there is no heater at that time, what will happen, that when the engine is stopped, slowly when it is circulating, a time will come, a temperature will start to fall down. And after that, the temperature will fall down from 78 inlet to 50 to 60 if the engine is stopped for a period of 8 to 10 hours. To ensure that the circulation temperature is maintained around 70 degrees Celsius, the water in a closed system is heated, and at that time the cooler is fully bypassed. The cooler is fully bypassed and the heater is heating the liquid by the use of a steam. To prevent a sudden thermal stress which may fall, because if the engine started and the temperature is around, suppose 58 to 60 degrees Celsius, and it will reach suddenly to the 75 to 80 degrees Celsius, that temperature reach from 58 to 78, 20 degree in a small span of time will cause huge thermal stress in a system, causing the material failure, may also cause leakage in the system. To prevent that, the heater is provided. To drain the system, cooling water drain tank is provided, which will drain in case we have to carry out any maintenance. So this is a simplified diagram which you can draw in your college exam. Okay, but for MEO class 2 and MEO class 4, you need to have an advanced knowledge of the temperature monitoring system. Basically the system is same, but there is a modification in the temperature control. So what happened basically, as you can see, this is the three-way control valve which you have seen here. Okay, now what is happening, that the water from the cooler, this cooler is coming, the water from LT cooling is coming here, and it passes through a deaeration vessels. Okay, this deaeration vessel is provided to remove any air present in the system. After passing through deaeration, it passes through a cooling water pump which also raises the temperature around 4 to 5 bar, and after that it passes through the inlet of the engine. Now here you can see there are two sensors provided, one is at the inlet and one at the outlet, and the inlet sensor is going to a master PID controller. Okay, this PID controller basically compare the inlet temperature with the set point. Means suppose we have set the temperature that we want to maintain temperature around 78 to 80 degree outlet temperature we want to maintain. So what it will check? It will check the difference with the inlet temperature. Suppose the inlet temperature is 68. So an outlet temperature we want to maintain here is 78. So set point is 78 and the inlet temperature of the engine is 68. So difference is 10. That difference will go here in the slave controller. Now the water going in, and after gaining the heat from the liner, exhaust valve and turbocharger, will come out from here, and again a sensor is provided. That sensor is going to a slave controller. Now what I have told you, this 10 degree difference is coming here and it is measuring. Suppose the temperature is 76, outlet temperature 76. So what it will see, that the outlet temperature is 76 and the difference is 8. It means that the difference between the outlet temperature 78 and 76 is 2 degree. So what it will do, the slave controller will send the signal to the master control valve, which will regulate the mixing of the incoming hot water and the cooled jacket water such that the temperature is maintained properly. So what is happening basically, the water coming from here, suppose having 76 degrees Celsius, so we need to increase the temperature so that it will around 78. So what it will do, it will increase the amount of mixing of hot water coming out from the jacket and will decrease the amount of cooled water from the jacket from the LT cooler. It means it will bypass the cooler little bit amount more, so that more mixing of hot water coming out from outlet will come and will mix, and such that the temperature of a system is overall will get risen up by 2 degree. As soon as it will get risen up, it will again throttle the thing. So basically by this method, means comparing both inlet and outlet temperature, it is measuring whether the system is properly following the correct temperature or not. Now, one more thing you can see that the outlet heat which is coming, it also been utilized for the fresh water generation. Means when the engine is running at full ahead, at that time the water coming out will come and will enter the freshwater generator and will provide the necessary heat for the evaporation of the seawater to produce fresh water, and will come out from here, go in, come out from here, and will come back like this. Now, one more thing you can see, a orifice is provided at the outlet of the jacket system. This is to provide restriction so that to ensuring the system is properly maintaining correct temperature and correct pressure. It is acting like a back pressure thing. Okay, now header tank is provided again for same thing, for maintaining any leakage in the system. It will maintain up and also providing a necessary passage for a vent. One more thing in the synopsis, I am going to tell you how this master and slave controller work. If you haven't understood that 68, suppose the inlet temperature, this is set point is 78, the difference is calculated and will fed to the slave controller. Slave controller has got the signal that 78 need to be maintained and 68 is the inlet temperature. So the outlet temperature will be measured, suppose it's 76. So what it will go, the difference is 2 degrees, it will go here and it will accordingly bypass the cooler such that the temperature of system is raised to the 78 degrees Celsius. Now suppose if the temperature is 80 degrees Celsius at that time and 78 is the feed temperature which we want, so if the temperature is high, it will bypass the jacket outlet temperature and it will allow more ST cooling water. By this mixing, regulating the mixing of outlet of the jacket water and the water coming from LT cooler, it is helping to maintain the correct temperature. Now, one more thing I want to tell you, that this system is called high temperature cooling circuit. Okay. And this pump is called high temperature cooling pump. This is the ST system, high temperature cooling water system. And the LT system is the different system. In ST system, provide the cooling to main engine, okay, and phase for generation. And the LT system provide the cooling for lube valve cooling system, piston cooling system, and necessary for also auxiliary cooling system. Okay, so the same thing is also with the heater here. As you can see, this heater is also doing the same thing as it was doing in the earlier diagram. It is allowing the necessary temperature need to be maintained when the engine is standstill condition. Okay, this preheater is provided with a preheater pump for circulation. Okay, so I hope you understand the modified diagram, advanced diagram of the cooling water system. If you like the video, so please share with your friend and please subscribe. Please don't go without subscription. Please subscribe so that it give me encouragement that you guys are liking my video, and hit the like button also. Thank you, friend. And please watch the part 2. It will be coming out soon. Thank you. Have a good day.